Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we are going to do a lesson on how to use a list in Microsoft Excel. I'm not sure if you have ever heard of data integrity, but what data integrity allows for is for your data to stay intact, and sometimes you want to only allow certain values to show up in a cell in Excel. One way you can accomplish this is by using a list that is limited to certain values so that you can avoid spelling errors or not put in information that doesn't belong in a certain cell. When using a list, sometimes you want to pull from a data source to have your information be limited to data from that data source. So today we are going to show you not only how to create that list, but also to create a list that you are able to search by just typing in a couple of characters and returning some legitimate results that will allow you to select from a limited list from your original data source. In order to accomplish that, we're going to have to use several functions today. The first function is the find function, which looks for a certain text called the search text, and it returns the position of the beginning of that search text from a search array. The second function is called the search function, and it does the exact same thing as the find function. It looks for a search text within a search array, and it returns a number for where the word in the search text is found in the string of the search array. The next function is called isNumber, and that one takes an input of a value, and it returns a true or false whether or not that value is a number. The next function we are going to use is a filter function, which takes an array and a true false whether or not this should be included. And what this function does is it allows you to filter out your data. And finally, we're going to use the sort function, which sorts a whole array of data alphabetically. So let's just say that I want to be able to enter the name of a song and return the artist, album, and decade. So over here, I have a tab called List. I'm going to click on that tab. And in this song field, I'm going to limit this field to only be existing songs in my data list. In order to do that, I'm going to go to the Data tab, go to this button over here that's called Data Validation, click the down arrow, and click Data Validation. Under Allow, I'm going to select the option for List. I'm going to click under Source, go back to the Data tab, and select the data that I wish to pick. This is the only column of data that I want available in this list. So then I'm going to click OK. Now, if you've noticed, a downward arrow has been added. When I click on that downward arrow, I will see all of the songs available in my list. So right now I'm going to select a song, but nothing else is happening. And I'm going to come here and use my trusty XLOOKUP function. I'm going to type equals XLOOKUP. My lookup value is going to be what's in column B, type a comma. My lookup array, or the list of data that is matching what is in column B, is going to be over here in column B of the data tab, type a comma. And then my return array is just going to be the rest of the table because I want it to spill over into those three columns. So after I type all of that and hit enter, I will now see once I select a song in column B, I will be returned with the artist, the album, and the decade from the data tab. So that's pretty straightforward. But what if I only wanted to type in part of a song and I want to limit this list because I have a lot of songs listed in here? What if I would like to come in here and only type the word you? If I do that, I'm going to come up with an error right here. So first of all, I would like to disable this error so that I'm able to type in a word. I can do that by going up here, going to data validation, going over to this error alert, and just turning off the error and clicking OK. So now if I come over here and I type in the word you and I pull down my list, I'm still being returned with every song. I don't want that. I want to limit this list to only the songs that have the word you in that. So how am I going to do that? If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. If I click on the Data tab and I look over here, I'm going to type the word you and press enter. Now, I'm going to go through several functions right here so that you can watch how I will limit this entire list here in column B to just those options that have the word you or whatever else I type in cell G2. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use a function called find equals find, and I'm going to type a left parenthesis. What is the text that I would like to find? First of all, I would like to find what is in here. I'm going to type a comma, and then where would I like to find that information? I would like to find that in column B. So I'm just going to highlight cells B3 to B19. and then I'm going to hit enter. You will see that I am now returned with a whole bunch of errors. But if you notice, the cells that are returning a number are actually the cells that have the word you in them. For example, in cell B6, I have wish you were here. And in cell B15, I have look what you made me do. So those are the two cells that are actually returning the value that I typed in to G2. So if I could get a list of just those songs when I type in the word you, that would be really great. But notice this. If I go in here and I type lowercase u and I hit enter, now all my cells are being returned with an error, even though the word you is found in those two cells. That's because when I use the find function, it's actually case sensitive. Instead of using find, I'm going to go up here and use the search function, which takes exactly the same arguments, except this one is not case sensitive. So watch what happens when I hit enter. Those values are coming up again, whether or not I have capitalized or not capitalized you. So right here, the search function is a lot better because it takes into account not having to match capital letters. So now that I have entered that in, I'm only being returned. This number down here is referring to where in that text string the word you is being found. So if I'm looking at wish you were here, you can see that this is the sixth character that is starting the word you. And when you look down here with 11, this is the 11th character that starts the word you. So one thing I want to do is in front of the search function, I actually want to return a true or false here instead of a number. Because when I go to use my next function after this, which is going to be the filter function is going to take an argument for true or false. And right now, I can return a true or false if there is a match here by using this function called isNumber. So I'm going to type that in front of the search function with a left parenthesis and then end it with a right parenthesis and hit enter. So now if you look at my column here, you can see there is a true being returned only in those cells where there is a match for the word that I've entered above. So this is good because this is going to be the second argument of my filter function. So now I'm going to use another formula in front of what I have right now. As you can see, I am nesting a formula within a formula. Now I'm going to use another one on the outside of that is going to take this true or false value. And that one is called the filter function. So I'm going to type filter with a left parenthesis. And now the filter is looking for an array to filter. The array that I want to filter in this case is everything that is showing up in column B. And I only want to return those results if they have a word that matches what I have typed in cell G2. So I'm going to type a comma, and you can see that the next argument is called include. Do I want to include that? True or false? And you can go back and see the results of my isNumber function, and I will want to return that. I'm going to put a closing parenthesis on the end and hit enter. And now you can see that I am being returned with only those words that have a match from what I've typed into cell G2. One more thing I would like to do. These are not in alphabetical order, and I would like to put that in alphabetical order. So I can put one more function in front of this nest of functions, and that one is going to be called the sort function. So I'm just going to type sort with a left parenthesis, end it with a right parenthesis, and hit enter. Now, everything in my list is in alphabetical order. So what I would like to do now is I would like to type a different word in here. I'm going to type the capital letter I and hit enter. And then you will see that this list just has anything with an I in it. Look down here at light my fire. You can see that it's not case sensitive because it has included a word with an I. But if I wanted to narrow this down a little bit more, I could come here and type the word me, and I'm returned with the songs that only have the word me in it. And again, they're not case sensitive. So you can see that this list is narrowing down more and more. What I would like to do in this case, I've tested the function here, but now I need to move it over to my list box that I'm using on the previous tab. To link this all together now, I would like to click in this cell, and instead of typing anything I want in here, I want to be able to type it in from where I'm getting my list. So I would like to type equals, go back to my list tab, and select cell B3, and hit enter. And right now I haven't put anything in cell B3, so you will be returned with an error. But the other thing I want to do, I want to go back to data validation. And instead of pulling from column B, this time I want to pull from this filtered column in column G that is using my spillover formula. So I highlight G, hit enter. And once I start typing in this cell, if I type the word me and I go down to my pull down list, I'm only being returned with the results that say me. If I go in here and I type I and go to my pull down list, I'm only being returned with anything that has an I in it. And if I go to type you, like I originally did, I'm only being returned with the results that have the word you in it. So when I select them on my XLOOKUP is still working correctly. So this is an example of how you would programmatically be able to start typing in a list field and be able to narrow down results from one column into a more narrow column and be able to select fewer options as you're typing. But keep in mind that those words have to be in order. You can't type perhaps you and then here. It's not going to find wish you were here because the word were is in the middle. It does still have to be in order, but it will still narrow down your choices for a field like this. So in summary today, we learned how to use a list box inside of Microsoft Excel to limit the results that can go inside of a cell. And then from there, we learned how to narrow down the number of items showing up in the list by typing in a string and using either the find or search function to see if that string is found in the list, using the isNumber function to return whether or not that string was found, using the filter function to filter out only those strings that have been found, and then using the sort function to sort those final results to show up in the list box. Hopefully you learned a little more about creating dynamic lists inside of Microsoft Excel this week. Thanks for watching our video and looking forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.